So this is my 2004 Bluebird International that I am putting up for sale. It is originally bus 147 for Wood County Schools out of Parkersburg, West Virginia. 2004 Bluebird International, 7.6 liter DT466E with the 6-speed Allison MD3060, though in the school buses they limited them to 5 speeds. It has 6 gears, but it'll only go up to 5th, so there are ways to get around that, but I have not done that yet. So it only goes up to 5th gear, and that is just how it came from the factory. It is a 72-passenger, 12-row. Still has all the seats. The only reason I'm getting rid of it is because I was going to restore it, but then insurance doubled on me, so now I got to get rid of it because I can't afford to keep it. But I have taken some things from it. Some of the things I've disconnected, like the student loading lights, all those are inoperable now. I took the flasher unit, the cross arm, the stop arm, and the warning lights are not connected, so none of it will work. I had other LED lights and stuff on here, but I put the lights that came with the bus back on it. They all work except for that little brake light right there. Now, the major things that this bus needs are all 6 tires, and the fuel tank has a very slow leak, somewhere between a quarter and a half full. But it has 11 R22.5 rims, or tires, sorry. It has 11 R22.5 tires. So, on the back you can get recaps, but on the steers it's illegal to have recaps. Recaps are typically cheaper, so that is a route that I would go. Also, up under the hood, I believe it is this right here, there's an O-ring in here that is leaking just very, very slightly, and it is spitting fuel all over the engine. I would go ahead and suggest doing the fuel filter when you do that, because you're going to have to prime the engine anyways. This bus does come with some parts and some other things, like all the oil and the filter for an oil change. I was going to do that, and then my insurance jacked up, so I figured I'll just go ahead and sell it and let the next person worry about the oil change. The alternator here, the wires that go to the starter, so it goes up from here up over the engine all the way to the starter. They will need replaced. You can get the wire and the ends at NAPA, but I don't know if they'll put them together for you. But you can see I put some electrical tape here and up here where it started to rub through, and to keep it from sparking. It needs front shocks too. I think this side is the one that is blown. I think that's because at Parkersburg High School they have speed bumps that really you can avoid, but only on the driver's side, so the passenger side has to go over it. Hood prop is disengaged. Now, this bus does have radiator shutters, so in the cold, it'll automatically shut them and keep heat in the engine. It's kind of like an automatic winter front, if you will. But it does have radiator shutters, which is neat, and I'm leaving my LED headlights in here for the next owner just because they are very handy. The old headlights, the stock headlights, are not very good. Those LEDs do wonders. We'll go inside and go over some things in here, and then we'll start it up and do another walk around just that way you can see everything that works and doesn't work. But right here, the switch panel. So what you got here, there's all your heat controls. You can see my phone is charging, that outlet does work. So there's my phone charging. Now the radio I swapped out, it is not wired up. It does not have a wiring harness to it. That radio does not work, so gonna have to get another radio for it if you want AM FM radio. I swapped the gauge cluster out, but not everything works on it. All of the gauges do work, but not all the lighting does. So basically you're going to have to get a paint conductive pin and just kind of redo some of those connections, and it should be fine. It's just some of the bulbs that don't work. Like the left turn signal indicator doesn't work. I know that much, but other than that, I don't know what doesn't. So I don't know what check engine lights or whatever don't work. But this bus had no check engine lights or anything of that nature before I replaced the gauge cluster. The reason I replaced the cluster was because the gauges quit working entirely. That is a common problem with these, but this was a used gauge cluster that had a lot less miles on it, and it worked fine. But I did swap out the hour meter and the odometer, so that is accurate, mostly. Where this bus, you know, the gauge cluster didn't work sometimes. Probably has more miles than what that says, but not by a whole lot. Like it says, 236, 496 is probably maybe 236, 700. That's really reaching. But it has a manual bifold door, so we'll zoom out here. Sorry to flip the video over, but I just think this is a better way to show that door. And now, you'll want to lift up on the handle to release it. But everything works as it should here. Non-tinted windows, brown seats and brown floor, white roof, which helps a little bit. Here are all the parts that are included with the bus. There's the oil. There's the door strut that they took off because they replaced the rear door, and I'll get to that here in a moment whenever we go back outside. One of the dome lights has trouble working sometimes, or I included another one of those. Here's some of the stock headlights in case you want to change them back. I changed the side turn signals on this bus, and I included the old ones. I don't really need them anymore. And then there's the oil filter that is included with the oil. So there's the parts that I'm including here. A lot of this stuff is just my stuff I need to get out of here still. I did put that cup holder in up there. We'll get back there in a moment. But I just wanted to show this bus. The floor is very solid. Very good shape structurally. It's just a few little minor things plus the tires and the fuel tank. Those are the two big issues it has. And really, they're not hard jobs. They're simple jobs, they're just time-consuming, or the tires are a little bit costly. But there are still ways to get around that. You can get used tires, and it will cost you near as much. It has a compartment here for tire chains and wheel chocks, and I will be taking that stuff out, but it does have a compartment here just for that. Kind of have to slam it shut. That's just the way these old buses are. But, let me start it up for you. We'll come back out here. That's what I meant to do. Start it up and we'll go. Turn the headlights on, the hazards on. All those lights are working. I might put another Bluebird logo there. I'm not 100% sure yet before it sells. Mainly all I gotta do is wash this thing before it sells because it is a little dirty. I will wash it. But here's the door. They put an older one on there after I bought it, before I picked it up, which I don't think they should have done that, but they did. Nothing I could do about it. But when they did that, they didn't put the strut back. Supposed to stop right about here with the strut, but it opens all the way. The screws should be in here somewhere, but the strut is included, and that's all good. Up underneath, you can't really see the brake lights where we're in the sun, but you can see the turn signals are working. You can see the brake lights are good, and that one's good. Turn signals. See, that one's good. That one doesn't work. This one's all good. I think that one just might need a bulb, and I can include a bulb if you want it. They're pretty cheap bulbs, though. Up under here, this is what it looks like up underneath. Very solid, like I said. Very good candidate for a restoration, and I'm selling this for less than I paid for it. Had to fight exporters on this, so of course, it went for a pretty penny whenever I bought it, and I'm selling it for less than what I have in it.
There's the rear tires.
I repainted the rims last summer. I took the stop arm off, as you can see. And here's the electrical panel. And I'm going to take a picture of, I have another Bluebird similar to this one, similar in age. I'm going to take a picture of the panel diagram over here, and I'll include that with the bus too. I may include that in the sale listing on Facebook Marketplace, which the video in the Marketplace listing will be cross-referenced, cross-linked. So, yeah. Here's the bus out here. I'll open the hood back up so that way we can see how it sounds and looks up underneath. Here's the front tires, which might have gotten a good look at earlier. Of course, this bus runs and it drives very well. I'm trying to list off all the issues that I know this thing has. Like I said, it's just a lot of little stuff, nothing too big. When you open the hood, you're going to have to disengage this hood prop if you want it to close, or else it will not close. That hood prop used to not work, and then something snapped up under here and it started working again. I think it was one of the springs was just getting caught on something, and it finally got loose, I think is what it was, honestly. I don't think anything actually broke, it just was a snapping sound. I don't necessarily have, I have other cross arm brackets, but they're too long. If you want one, I can include one of those. I haven't found one to replace that yet, but those are pretty easy to come by. Just have to measure it and go to a junkyard and find one, or order one online from a bus parts website. But it is a very nice bus, and I hate to get rid of it. See, like I said with the indicators, the right one's working, but the left one's not, so. Does drive forward. It does brake and stop, and it does go backwards. Trying to think of what else I could say in this video. I'm trying to think of everything. Go ahead and turn these dome lights on so we can see what I was talking about with the dome light that didn't work, which is right here. These have LED bulbs in them, so all you have to do is change the bulb out if you want to keep the LED bulbs. Or I still have the old bulbs that were in here like this. I can throw these in here. These are very bright at night. But basically it's just two screws, or three screws. There's one that is basically going to go like this. There's one right here that actually holds it to the bus. These two just hold the lens on, and then just splice the wire and put it all back together. Very easy. I replaced a couple of these before. Like I said, I put that cup holder in here. It's got a driver's compartment there. It's got a driver's compartment right here. I'm going to take all my stuff out of it before I sell it. Here's some information. There's a picture of this in the Marketplace listing. And here's this. This is the Bluebird information. If you know how to use a Bluebird Vantage, there's that. So, this bus was retired in April of 2022, and I bought it in February of 2023, and it has treated me very well. It's never given me any real issues. Everything that I can think of right off the top of my head, I have mentioned, but please come see this thing yourself, look it over, and I'm not going to entertain any offers until somebody has actually looked it over and seen what they thought. So please don't make me any offers until you've actually come to look at it and, you know, you've seen it, you know what kind of condition it is in firsthand. Unless you want to offer me more than my asking price, come and get it. Also, I am limiting this to USA buyers only because West Virginia and their property taxes and such, I would rather just sell it to somebody in the United States and make sure that they register it, or at least get it out of my name. I don't care what you do as long as it's not in my name anymore. Because exporters, you know, like I said, I fought exporters on this, and they like to buy these Bluebird Internationals. So you might even be able to buy it from me and sell it to them for a profit. I don't know. That is up to you, but I just don't want to deal with the paper trail and all that fun stuff. So I am asking $5,000 or best reasonable offer. Like I said, don't make me an offer until you come to see it. Very good bus, in very good shape, and I hate to get rid of it. But it's just the more cost-effective thing for me to do now. It will come with all the maintenance records that Wood County had with it. The only thing I'm keeping from those maintenance records are all the handbooks and stuff, which you don't really need. I just like to collect that kind of stuff. So, all the maintenance records. I didn't get any of the service record. I got a little bit of the service records, like whenever they changed a couple of lights on the back or whatever, but or change, I think, a pipe to the turbo. That'll go with you, too. I don't need all that. But you can see how often this thing was maintained. The engine was rebuilt in April of 2011, I think, at 108,000 miles. So this does have a remanufactured engine in it, or at least they tore it down and rebuilt it. It's not showing any signs that I know of really needing that again. So I'm not incredibly mechanically inclined, but I can tell. I mean, I'm a school bus driver as a job, and I am a collector and enthusiast as a hobby, and I can tell when a bus is in good shape, and this one is in very good shape. But you can contact me on the Facebook Marketplace listing, or you can email me at busproject681@gmail.com. The bus is located in Barboursville, West Virginia, area code 25504. So it's up for sale. Look in the comments if you're interested. I will post a comment saying when it is gone. So please just make sure that you look at the comments too, because if you continue to ask me if it's for sale, then I'm just not going to respond. But appreciate you guys being interested. You know how to get a hold of me. Please come look at this thing, drive it around the storage lot here for yourself, or I can take you out on the road in it if I still have insurance on it, which I'll have insurance until about mid-May, I think. So I went ahead and paid the bill, but after about mid-May, it's getting canceled because I can't afford it anymore. So I will still be driving it a little bit. Now I showed the mileage off. I still will be driving it a little bit, getting my enjoyment out of it and getting my money's worth out of the insurance too. But the mileage shouldn't go up that much. It'll be staying local. Won't be going very far. But I guess that'll be it. You know how to get a hold of me.